come on, come on.
I have an appointment to play a game of chess with Mr. Field, our landlord. Come on, will you shake a leg? Please, will you press the pants?
Abbott, what are you getting so excited about? Your date ain't with the girl until tonight.
So what about it? Now, when I take you out with girls, don't we always split 50-50?
Yes. Mm-hmm. You always split the girls 50-50.
That's right.
You always take the ones under 50 and give me the ones over 50.
That's a... Oh, boy, that's the baby. Hey, go ahead, press the pants. Take it easy. Now, don't get excited. Don't get excited. Take it easy. Hello?
I want to talk to Lou Costello.
All right. Costello!
Yeah?
It's for you.
Whoever it is, tell them I'm busy. I am pressing your panties.
Come on, take your own messages.
Okay.
Hurry. Hello, my social life. Hurry. Hello.
Is that you, Lou Costello?
Yeah, this is Lou Costello. It ain't his brother, Pat.
Are you sure this is Lou Costello?
I am positive. This is Lou Costello. Hiya, Lou Costello. Hi. Hello, Mr. Fields. How do you do? Yes, I am positive. I am Lou Costello.
You don't sound like Lou Costello.
Well, what do you want me to do? I mean, I'm Lou Costello. I know who I am. I'm Costello. I got certificates there to prove I'm Lou Costello.
Well, listen, Costello. This is Dinky's brother. I want you to bring me the $5 you owe me.
When he gets in, I'll tell him.
Hey, Abbott, I want to thank you for buying me this new tie and the shirt and the pants. Must be Sid Fields. I figured it was you.
You did, huh?
Here's your $20. I was only kidding.
You're giving me $20?
On account.
On account of what?
That's all I got.
That's all you got. Well, you're going to have more, and I'm going to have more, because it'll take more to pay the rent that you owe me.
What are you cooking up now?
There is going to be the dawn of a new day in the life of Lou Costello.
What's going to happen?
You are going to work.
Hey, Abbott!
What's the matter?
I've just been telling this boy that things are going to change around here. I've got to have my rent, and there's only one way to... You remember the fellow that used to live upstairs? This fellow, Leo Whitcup, that was the door-to-door salesman?
Oh, Leo Whitcup.
Yeah.
The guy with the hiccups. I used to call him Whitcupper, the hiccupper.
He moved out without paying his rent.
So?
He left a whole room full of these things, and you're going out and sell them.
What are these?
No peddlers allowed.
No peddlers allowed.
That's right.
You want us about, we're going to sell this?
You've got to sell them. Somebody's got to sell them. Don't you realize there's over 50 million women in this country who have no protection from these imbeciles who go door to door peddling things? This poor housewife, she's in her apartment. She's watching the television set while she does her work. It's a daytime serial. Little Nell is about to be thrown out of her house because she can't pay her rent. Her uncle is being barbecued in the fireplace. The doorbell rings. She runs to the door. She answered, who is it? It's a peddler, one of these idiots who comes to sell her something. By the time she gets back into the house, the daytime serial is over. She's missed the entire climax. And what happens? Her whole day is ruined.
Where'd this lady live?
Where does she live? She lives all over the country. Madison, New Jersey, Ashton, Wisconsin, Maquanago, everywhere. She lives all over America.
I'm not going to even go to Maquanago. I came to say it. I'm not going to go over the world looking for this lady. If she's around next door, so I'll go look for her.
It doesn't make any difference, me.
Where is Maquanago?
What's the difference? Maquanago is next to Oconomowoc. And by selling these signs, you'll not only be helping that housewife to see the climax of these wonderful daytime serials, but you'll be helping yourself by earning the money to pay your room rent.
Hey, you know, Mr. Fields has got something there. I'm with him 100% on that. You should take these out, go from door to door, and sell as many as you can.
Yes.
That's right.
And you're going to help him.
And I'm going to...
Yeah? What do you want?
I'm here to do you a favor. A big favor.
Like what?
Like selling you one of these no peddlers allowed signs.
Well, now, isn't that just it?
I know you'd go for it.
You're trying to drive door-to-door salesmen out of business. Let them starve to death.
Why not? They're nothing but pests. Public nuisances. place one of these here on your door and your troubles are all over.
I happen to be a door-to-door salesman, so you take this and my troubles will be over.
Hey.
Well, what do you want?
How do you do, sir? Do you realize what it is to have peddlers pester you all day long?
Say, listen. I've got one of the greatest little gadgets here you ever saw. Keep peddlers out of your hair the rest of your life. They're 50 cents a piece or two for a dollar.
I'll take the two for a dollar.
Good.
Yes, sir.
You got a bargain.
You want two for a dollar. No peddlers allowed. No peddlers allowed. He's in the same business that I'm in.
What do you want?
Lady, do you ever look at television or listen to radio?
I was just watching my favorite daytime serial, Little Nell, when you so rudely interrupted me.
Well, you see, lady, that's the idea. You buy one of my no peddlers allowed signs, and never again will you be bothered by pests. Uh-oh. Must have got Little Nell.
You just made me miss the big climax. Why, you...
Naughty, naughty. Don't do that, lady. That's on me. Oui. What's the idea of leaning on my doorbell? You annoy me.
You're gonna love me when you find out I'm selling no peddlers allowed signs. You place one of these on your door, you're rid of the pests forever. What do you say? Yeah, this'll make a hit with you.
This'll make a hit with you.
Well, what do you want?
How do you do, sir? I would like to make you a very contented man. How would you like to buy one of my no peddlers allowed signs?
I'm not interested, so scram.
Now, hold it, just a minute. I'm not so easily discouraged. I gotta sell one of these before I go. And you must buy one if you don't mind.
Get lost.
This, what? Mama? You get dunked over the head? There's a frying pan and pull the tie? At least I'm a gentleman like anybody else. You got, all right. Who are you? Come on, I defy you to come out.
Come to my doorbell again and I'll break your neck.
I'm sorry.
Now beat it. What are you doing now?
I caught the door.
Well, that's no way to sell these signs.
I know that. Though.
Well, go ahead, get away. What's the matter with it?
Listen, this guy's tough on you. He told me to keep away from here.
All right, ring the bell. He'll open the door and you get your tie out.
Don't ring the bell.
Why?
He'll open up the door. He'll smear me all over the job.
Oh, why don't you stop with me alongside of you? What are you worrying about? Here, I'll ring the bell.
Don't ring the bell.
Well, you're still here. This ought to take care of you.
Excuse me, could you tell me where Hope Street is?
It's about three blocks down that way. I gotta get back.
Sorry, I ripped the new pants you bought
me. You should be sorry. What do you think? I find these things in the street?
That's what we left, isn't it?
Yeah. Come in. Oh, hello, Mr. Fields.
Well, boys, I see it didn't go so good, huh?
No, not so good.
Well, I got another idea.
No more of your ideas. Your ideas is worse than Abbott's. No more.
Wait a minute. Keep, hold still.
Calm down.
Hold still a minute.
Now, be careful. You've got to pay your rent, and this is a way to get some finances.
Now, what? Now, you know those two boys that moved in upstairs in that vacant room? You know,
yeah.
Steve and Tom?
Yes.
Well, they're in trouble again.
Uh-oh.
They're in trouble.
Will
you hold still?
Hey, give them those signs, no peddlers. Let them sell it.
Never mind. This is a real kind of trouble. They've got a problem this time. You see, these two guys are stuck on two sisters.
Yeah.
Now, these sisters have a very eccentric old man. Their father is a collector of rare birds and guns. He also has collected a rare hatred for Steve and Tom. Why? Because these two guys are a couple of tough guys, and he won't let them get within a mile of his house or his daughters.
Mm.
Now, that's where you boys come in.
Wait a minute. I'm a little leery about those two guys. They play too rough.
Oh, they're perfect gentlemen.
Mr. Fields.
What?
Please get out while he's sewing up the pants.
Yeah, all right.
Take it easy.
You are not going to do anything else. Now, go.
They may give you boys as much as $100. If you boys will go to the house, decoy the two girls out of the house, away from the old man, so these two boys, Tom and Steve, can step in and have a date with them.
Oh, you might have something there.
The boys promised to meet me right after lunch. Okay if I bring them down here?
Sure, it's okay.
All right, boys, remember, you'll get $50 apiece and I'll get my rent.
Oh.
Okay, Mr. Fields, we'd be very glad to accommodate you and the boys at $50 apiece.
Abbott. Abbott, where's Abbott?
Abbott, he's over here. He ripped his pants, too.
Oh, here's the boy.
Oh, hi, Ralph.
Well, Abbott, you're just busting to help us outsmart old man Thomas.
Just say we're busting to forget the whole thing.
Now, wait a minute. Fields says you help us, and you're not going to back out on us now.
You boys have got to help him out, and you're the only ones who can. You see, old man Thomas, the father of the two girls these fellas go for, doesn't know Abbott and Costello. So you get into the house, get the girls out, and the boys will step in and have a date.
I got it. What you want us to do is go to the house, meet the girls, bring the girls out, put them in your hands, we're through.
And you get the money.
That's right. We'll be back in a half an hour with the car.
June and Marie will be expecting you. Just to make sure you make a good impression on old man Thomas, talk birds to him. He's nuts on the subject.
He likes birds, huh?
Oh, birds?
Nah,
now, boys, I'm going to give you a little something on account. Costello, I'm giving you 20. Abbott, I'm giving you 22.
Good.
Hold it. You give me 20, you give him 22? How come you give him $2?
I didn't. I gave Abbott $20 and I gave you 22.
You did?
Yeah.
Certainly.
Give me
22.
$300. That's all good. Pick him up. Be back in a half an hour.
Okay.
Let's go.
Come on, fellas.
Okay,
wait a minute.
Just thought of something. You thinking of the same thing?
Yes, sir.
The birds?
The birds.
You've got to know something about birds to talk to the old man intelligently.
Do you know anything about birds?
Oh, I think I know enough to get away with it. Yeah, I know a lot about birds.
Do you know what a mugwump is?
A mugwump?
Yeah.
Oh, yes. A mugwump is a little bird that sits on a fence all day.
A mugwump sits on a fence all day?
Yes. And his mug hangs over one side of the fence, and his wump hangs over the other.
Now, children, now we have something. Here is our new antenna made in the shape of a birdcage. Of course, it's quaint, but I know it'll work. Isn't it a wonder? The old one up on the roof, my dear. That's the end of that. That absolutely must go.
Oh, Henry Thomas, have you gone out of your mind?
Hmm?
What's wrong with the antenna we've got on the roof?
My darling, I can explain that in exactly two words. It stinks. We get nothing but snow, and a lot of frightful distortions.
Oh, but, Daddy, you can't put this thing up there this afternoon.
Oh, is that so, and why not?
Because there's a man up on the roof repairing it, and you'd just get in his way. Besides, Daddy, Mr. Abbott and Mr. Costello, the gentlemen we met at the lecture, are calling on us, and you've got to stay here and meet them, Daddy. You'd look kind of silly trying to say hello to them from the roof.
Will I ever win a decision around here? All right. I'll put the thing aside until after they've gone. After all, any inconvenience is quite all right with me, as long as it can get my two dizzy daughters' minds occupied with something besides those two horrible, worthless fellows, that Tom and that Steve.
Oh, Father, you'll just be crazy about Mr. Abbott and Mr. Costello.
Oh, that's so.
Oh, they're so intelligent. The kind that are interested in the finer things, like arts and sciences.
Oh, dear.
And, Daddy, their hobby is the study of dogs and birds.
Birds? Oh. Oh, birds. Our little feathered friends. Well, then. We really ought to get along wonderfully. Excuse me, children.
Oh, Daddy.
Oh, pardon me, dear.
Oh, Henry, be careful.
Well, I'll just put it right out here on the porch.
There's the Thomas house. Now go in and do your stuff and be sure you don't fall down on the job.
Don't worry about us. We'll deliver the girls.
You'd better, or else things could get very rough for you.
I'm not worried about you, Abbott, but this guy ain't got the brains of a 5-year-old child.
Yeah, but look at the difference in our ages.
Thank goodness we got your father out of here before your friends came. I'd hate to have him disgrace us in front of Mr. Abbott and Mr. Costello.
Oh, yeah, especially if he gets started on one of those cockeyed discussion of birds.
Oh, don't worry. I'll keep him out of here until you girls have a chance to make your friends feel at home.
You don't know how much this date means to us, Mother.
I know, dear.
Mother doesn't know it, but she's on our side.
Come on, we'd better let the decoys in.
But these girls are a couple of beauts.
Nonsense. We're here on business.
What do you do?
Jude and Marie Thomas, I presume?
Why, yes. But when Steve described you over the phone, we didn't expect such a pleasant surprise as this.
Well, I should say not. You're no monster. You're cute.
Monster?
Come on, let's go over here and get acquainted.
Excuse us, please?
Oh, yes.
Why, certainly.
Come on, girls, get your hats. We've got to deliver you to Tom and Steve.
Abbott, don't be so impatient.
All of a sudden, I'm not in such a hurry.
That makes two of us.
Hey, will you shut up?
Why now, go have a little chat over here.
No, we can't afford to chat now. I don't want the boys to get impatient.
Oh, that'll keep.
Now, wait a minute.
Come on, cutie pie. Sit down.
After you, June. Gorgeous.
Oh, you have such soulful eyes. They do something to me. You know, I think you're an awful lot nicer than Tom.
I think you are, too.
I'd like to get really acquainted with you. The real you.
Well, I gotta deliver you to Tom.
Never mind, Tom. He can wait. Oh, don't you like girls?
I like them very much, but I didn't know that... Excuse me?
Well, then why don't you sit close to me?
Well, I'm sitting as close as I want to sit.
Come on.
Please, I mean, after all, I don't... I know, but I mean, after all, I don't want to...
It takes you a long time to get warmed up, but once you do, you're a ball of fire.
Lou, come on, please. Tom and Steve are waiting. You're burning me up now.
I'm burning you up. I was just burnt. Oh.
Lou wants to stay here and hold hands with me, don't you, Lou?
Well, what's all these strange sounds going on here? These strange noises.
Oh, did you hear me?
Dad, Mother, I'd like you to meet Mr. Abbott and Mr. Costello.
Well, gentlemen, this is a pleasure indeed. Mr. Costello, Mr. Abbott. Well, Mother, isn't it wonderful? Two intelligent young men here to visit our daughters.
Yes, the girls told us that you were very intelligent young men.
Yeah. I was teaching your daughter here all about bird calls.
Oh, bless your heart. Then you must be the one that knows all about birds. An ornithologist.
What?
An ornithologist.
Oh, sure. First class.
Mm-hmm. You do know all about the birds, the lovely little feathered creatures.
Oh, I love birds. Mm-hmm. What's your favorite bird?
Well,
what's your favorite bird call?
Well, I think the sweetest call in all birdland is the call of the whippoorwill.
The whippoorwill?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, I like the call of my bird better.
Is that so? Which species is that?
The whippoorwill.
Whippoorwill? I never heard of it. Whippoorwill? What's the difference between the whippoorwill and the whippoorwill?
Well,
the whipper will and the whipper won't. Yeah, the whipper won't what? That's it.
Oh. You know, really, you're a quaint chap. I was telling the boys down at the Bird Watchers Club all about him.
You remind me of a little bird.
Oh, dear, oh, dear.
Cuckoo, will you?
Well,
what
Jack.
What do you got here?
Oh, this gentleman is my own creation. It is a new antenna. I made it all with my own hands, and I made it in the form of a birdcage.
Isn't that beautiful? What are you doing?
You know, when this is installed, I will get the clearest pictures in this whole neighborhood. Yes. It must be adjusted to the roof, you see. Must be very firmly anchored to the roof.
The television ain't working out?
Yes, but this is a very superior set, and I'm quite sure that the pictures will be absolutely beautiful.
Yeah.
And at 2:30 this afternoon, gentlemen, there's going to be a wonderful bird program.
No, what?
Oh,
please.
A little bird program about little birds?
Yes.
Oh, I want to see it, Abbott.
See, I knew Mr. Costello would love to see that, wouldn't you?
But how can you see that program until you have your antenna set up?
Yes. Oh, dear. Well, now, isn't that silly of me? Of course. Well, if you'll excuse me, gentlemen, very nice to have known you. I must climb up on the roof
just
now.
Just a minute. We've got to get out.
Excuse me, Abbott. Be debonair. Be chivariles. Chivarolas or something.
Don't mind, sir. Do you mind if Abbott and I help you put this antenna up on the roof?
Oh, you're too kind, really.
I mean, after all, we are much younger than you are, and I think that high attitude up there might make you a little dizzy, and I think we can do it.
Well, thank you very much. Just a little help. I tell you what I'll do. If you'll be kind enough to take the antenna, I will get you the tools and the ladder.
Thank you, sir.
Get out of here.
I'm going to listen to a little bird program tomorrow.
Look out.
What are you guys doing up here with that bird cage?
No bird cage. We're putting up an antenna for Mr. Thomas.
Well, keep out of my way while I work. Now, be careful where you walk. There's some weak spots in this roof.
Well, dangerous, huh?
Yeah.
Well, thanks for the tip. My name is Bud Allen.
Glad to know you. And,
Why are you laughing? Come on, let's put it up over here.
If Abbott and Costello don't bring the girls out pretty soon, I'm going in after them.
If they're double-crossing us, we'll mop up the place with them.
Right. We'll give them 10 minutes more.
Come on, get up on here. Give me a hand.
Hold on.
Here, get that barrel in. Hurry up. You make it?
Yeah.
Good boy. Take it easy now. Wait, your idea, you know, not mine.
Yeah, wait.
Yeah, now hold on to that.
Okay.
Lift it up a little.
Take it
easy. Now, wait a minute.
Don't knock that.
Well, wait a minute. Please, I want to get some solid spots here.
What are you knocking out the bricks for?
Hold still. Now, wait a minute. Hold still. Yeah. Oh, now, hold it tight. That a boy. Hold it tight. Lou, where did you go to now? Lou, come up. Lou. Oh, no. Come on, get up out of there.
I'm stuck. I can't get up.
Huh?
I'm stuck. I can't get up.
Come here, I'll give you a hand. Oh, this tar is terrible. Now, wait a minute. Oh.
Wait a minute. I'll help you.
Thanks.
Woo!
Get me up!
Woo! Woo!
Accident.
One more accident, and I'm gonna get mad.
Hey, what are them jokers doing playing around on the roof, huh?
I don't know, but we're going up there and take care of them.
Let's go.
Henry, for heaven's sake, relax. No. Sit down.
My. I hope they get that antenna fixed so we won't miss that bird program.
So do I. So Marie and I can have the boys to ourselves.
Yeah, but that bird program, I've been looking forward to that. Oh, my, what's taking them so long?
Abbott, I'll chop a hole in the roof and we'll anchor it here.
I hope you're right, boy. Oh, hey, trouble.
Why don't you bring the girls out?
What are you guys
playing around up here for?
Get it low. Get it
Mother, look. A perfect specimen of the Homo vatipus. I must shoot that and stuff it.